Recording now.
Hello, everyone. I want to talk to you about something that we should all never stop doing as a believer. Everyone knows bad habits are hard to break and poor behavior is hard to stop. But there's one thing that all believers should never stop doing, no matter how old you are, how young you are, no matter how mature a believer you are, whether you're an elder in the church or you're in full-time ministry or you're a professional in the marketplace. There's one thing that all believers should never, ever, ever stop doing. My name is Rachel Anderson, and I'd like to share with you what that one thing is. For the next few minutes, I want to share with you what that one thing is, why it's so important, what the consequences are if we stop doing it, and what the benefits are if we continue to do it. So first of all, the one thing that I'm talking about is drawing closer to the Lord. That's one thing we can never, ever stop doing. So you might say, well, why is drawing closer to the Lord so important? Well, imagine a husband and wife relationship. Well, imagine the wife, they got married, and the husband would just say, you know, I love you. I'm so glad we're married now, but I'm moving to the other side of the earth. Don't worry, I love you. And if I need to get a hold of you, if I need you, I know where you are. I'll reach out to you, but I'm so glad you married me. Imagine if we did that to God, and truth is, that is what we do to the Lord. Sometimes we say to him, thank you for saving me. I love you so much, God. And you know, there's some things I need to do. I need to go away for a while. I need to take some time to do some other things. And what that does is make a distance between you and God. And we say, but God, I know where you are. I know you love me. And if I need to reach out to you, I'll let you know. How awful is that? We can't do that to the Lord, because in every relationship, as we've seen in the natural with a husband and wife, we need to nurture those relationships. We need to communicate. We need to spend time regularly. We need to get to know each other in a deeper, more personal, more intimate way. So that's what we're talking about as believers. We can never, ever stop drawing closer to the Lord as the most important relationship that we will ever have in our lifetime. So why do we need to draw closer to the Lord beyond the husband and wife scenario I just explained? Let's look at the scripture. The scripture says that we might know him. It says in Philippians 3:10 that we might know him and the power of his resurrection and the fellowship of his sufferings being made conformable unto his death. So it's so important that we know him intimately, the things that he went through. Sometimes when we go through things in life, we want to know that the people that love us understand what we are going through or what we have been through. We want to understand the Lord Jesus and what he went through for us. Another reason that we need to draw closer to the Lord is that he might know us. Psalm 138:6 says, "The proud he knows afar off." Some translations say, the proud he knows from a distance. So we want God to know us intimately. Like, we don't want to have a long distance relationship with the one who loved us so much that he gave his life for us. Thirdly, Jesus prayed and asked the Father that we would be with him where he is, that we would be one with him and with the Father, and that we would all be one. You can read this in John 17, verses 20 to 23. So we looked at what are the reasons why we need to draw closer to the Lord. Now let's look at some of the consequences for not doing so. There are some rather serious consequences of not drawing closer to the Lord. One of those are doing things that are not pleasing to him. The Israelites in the Old Testament made a golden calf and bowed down to it and worshipped it. You can find that in Exodus chapter 32, verse 1. What they did was they risked the wrath of God. God is a loving God, but he's also a fearsome God, and he has a standard. And he said, you shall have no other gods before me. And they didn't know their heavenly Father. They didn't know God Almighty. Had they known him, they would have known that was not pleasing to him and would have saved themselves the grief of the consequences they suffered later. Another reason or consequence for not drawing closer to God is missing out on his virtues. Psalm 103 says, forget not all his benefits. There are benefits that there is to knowing God, his promises, what he has for us as children of God, his mercy and his forgiveness, When we've done something wrong, we need to know our Heavenly Father loves us and He will forgive us. He is faithful. And we need to know we can come back to Him and He will receive us once we repent. But if we don't know Him, we don't know firsthand His mercy and His forgiveness, we will stay afar off and we will keep our sin, we will keep our shame and our condemnation. And God doesn't want that. He wants us to come to Him freely. We also need to know Him as our healer, our provider, and our comforter. And those are some of the virtues and the benefits we get from knowing Him. Another one, a serious consequence that I've really appreciated knowing, is in Matthew 7, verses 21 to 23. Jesus is speaking and He says, "Not everyone who says to me, 'Lord, Lord,' shall enter into the kingdom of heaven, but he who does the will of my Father which is in heaven." Now pause for a minute. You might be thinking, well, you're in full-time ministry, you pray for the people, you prophesy, you cast out demons, and all surely those things are doing the will of God. But this is what Jesus says if you continue reading. He says, "Not so." Jesus says, "Many will say to me, 'Lord, Lord, we've prophesied in your name. We've cast out demons. We've done all these wonders.'" And what did Jesus say? He didn't say, "Well done, you've done the will of the Father." He said, "Depart from me, I never knew you." Now think about that. God is omniscient, meaning He knows all. But He says, "I never knew you." That's speaking of relationship. You didn't take the time to come and know Him. You were doing works. And He wants to build a relationship with you. He wants to know you, and He wants you to know Him in return. Lastly, another reason, a consequence for not drawing closer to the Lord, is you might become stagnant in your relationship to God. You risk camping out on a disaster or a victory. You never want to do that. No matter what's happened to you, you want to be able to dust yourself off and keep going. If you're on a mountaintop, you want to keep drawing closer to Him for the next steps of what He has for you. Philippians 3, 13 to 14 says, "Forgetting those things that are behind and reaching for the things that are before, I press towards the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus." So we want to remember that God's come through for us in a miraculous way, or He's given us a deep revelation. It's not good enough to just stay there and sit on it. Yes, we want to absorb everything that He has given to us, be grateful for what He's done for us, but it doesn't mean we stay there. We want to keep growing. We want to keep drawing closer to the Lord no matter what, whether it's a victory or a disaster or something terrible that has happened. We don't want to stagnate in our relationship with God. Now let's just look at a few of the benefits of drawing closer to God. "Draw near to God and He will draw near to you," James 4 verse 8 says. When we draw near to God, we stay clean. Why I say that, if you look at Mark chapter 1 verse 15, it says, "The kingdom of God is at hand." At hand means it's close. But it also says, repent and believe the gospel. So the kingdom of God is near, and it's telling us to repent because the kingdom of God is near. When we look at that, we can look back at James 4:8, which says, "Draw near to God, and He will draw near to you." But then the next sentence says, "Cleanse your hands, you sinners, and purify your hearts, you double-minded." So you can see the similarities between the two chapter verses. Repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand. Draw near to God, and He will draw near to you. But you need to cleanse your hands and purify your hearts. So in order to get into the kingdom of God, which is near, in order to draw near to God as He draws near to you, we need to stay clean. And as we continue to draw near to Him, there's a purifying and a sanctification that happens to us along the way. Another benefit for drawing closer to the Lord is that we will know Him and the power of His resurrection, a verse that I mentioned earlier. But let's look at why is it important to know the power of His resurrection. Because resurrection power is life. We need the power to overcome the darkness in this world. No one will dispute that there's a lot of darkness, there's a lot of spiritual warfare that's going on, there's a lot of things that come at us, and we need the spiritual resurrection power of Jesus Christ in our life. We need to know God's power so that we can overcome and I know you overcome by the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony. And we need to be able to speak God's word by knowing who He is, spending time in His word, spending time in His presence. Another reason is the promises of God, what He has provided for us as His children. We come to know that as we draw nearer to Him, as we partake of His word daily, sitting at His feet, listening to Him speak to us, leading us to know Him as healer, as provider, as comforter. And lastly, and there are very many more benefits, these are just the ones that I chose to share with you today, we need to draw near to God so that we can hear His voice. In these days, we need to know what God is saying to us. We need to know where to go, when to go, if to go. We need to be so close to Him that we can hear Him speak to us and order our conversation, order our steps, so we can be in the right place at the right time. And that we get from drawing closer to the Lord. So in conclusion, today we talked about what we must all keep doing to draw closer to God, the importance of it, why we need to do it, the consequences of not doing it, and the benefits we get from doing it. Now, what we should do is we need to pray. We need to ask the Holy Spirit to show us. Holy Spirit, show me what things I need to do. What areas of my life have I camped on? Have I become stagnant? Have I become resistant? Have I not repented or yielded to you? So spend some time in a quiet place and call on the Lord and ask Him, show me, Lord, show me where I've missed it. Show me where I can grow further with you. In future videos, I'll be sharing more ways we can all continue to draw closer to the Lord. If you like my video, you can visit my website. It says, Keep Drawing Closer. And if you like this teaching, please remember to hit the subscribe button. And I'll see you on the next video. Thanks so much for watching.